Wrestling Rampage here, back with another video. I'm Tommy, accompanied by Long Hair and the Finger Poke a Doo.
I'm Joey, along with old Black Cap and old Suplex Apparel over here.
Y'all know me. As sad as it is, I'm their father. My name's Thomas.
With that being said, this is 5 questions with Wrestling Rampage. These are questions asked by you guys, the viewers of Wrestling Rampage, that you guys sent us to answer. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, facebook.com/WrestlingRampage2. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter, @WrestleRampage. Hit that subscribe button because we're going to be bringing you guys more and more videos. And don't forget to also donate February 4th.
Donate to Connor's Cure.
Connor's Cure.
Tell them Wrestling Rampage sing.
That's right, even though they probably won't give a shit. Yeah. But anyway, with that being said, we'll go ahead and get started with 5 questions with Wrestling Rampage, because you guys have been sending us questions like crazy.
I love this.
And people even say that this is one of their favorite videos that we do. So with that being said, we'll go ahead and get started with the first question. And this is asked by our good New Zealand friend, awesome dude, Brio35. Go and subscribe to his YouTube channel. He's awesome.
Yes.
He's a real awesome guy.
Puts on great videos.
That's right. Actually, he done a day in the life of a wrestling fan for an entire week.
Yeah.
And I watched that video. It was awesome.
Yes, it was.
He's also doing a part of how he got to be a pro wrestling fan and everything. Very, very cool little series of videos to do. So with that being said, we'll go and get started. Almost choked on myself there, but first of all, here we go. Outside of pro wrestling, what else do you enjoy?
Like I said, I enjoy football, basketball, baseball. I'm not a big fan of baseball.
I like that golf.
No, fuck golf. by the way, Tiger Woods sucks.
I wish I would Tiger Woods.
Not now.
maybe he 2002. Money to pay for that.
What else?
Maybe them wrestling, of course. Not indie wrestling. Some of it's okay, but not like Kenny Omega and the Young Bucks.
Well, actually, here soon, I'm hoping that we can go to OVW.
That'd be good.
Because OVW is Ohio Valley Wrestling. They come to town, our town.
Yep.
About every month, except for December, they didn't come. But every month they do come here.
Yes.
And we try to go when we can.
Yeah.
But
yeah, I enjoy football, basketball. I like the Chicago Bears, and I'm not a Dallas fucking Mavericks fan. They're Vince.
Vince!
And fuck you, you fucking...
This is brought to you by Surge.
Yeah, I like the Chicago Bulls. I'm a Chicago Cubs man. And I like to play video games. That's about it.
I like to watch football, basketball. I'm not really a big fan of baseball. I play video games. I watch a lot of wrestling. I like doing, you know, I like going to stores, looking around. I ain't been for a while, but I also like to fish. I also like to hunt. I guess it's just just a natural, you know, person to just like what they like to do. And but I tell you, I of all the things that I like and enjoy, this.
Outside of pro wrestling, I enjoy spending time with my son. Being divorced, there's always a time constraint on how much time you can spend with your child because there's always that parent. But I like to spend time with my son. I like to do a lot of art stuff sometimes, draw, things of that nature, which I haven't been able to do lately, but video games, love doing video games. I love going to stores, certain stores, and looking around. You know, and finding wrestling stuff.
And you guys know that.
Oh,
you
yeah.
know.
You all try to look for wrestling.
Yeah, we all try to.
And
look,
see, sometimes you know
we would dig for it.
We don't even like we don't even go into some traditional stores. Like, yeah, you can always go to Walmart and things like that. There's also thrift stores you can go to and find some
flea markets,
things of that nature.
And we have actually dug for stuff.
Oh yes, actually, and you go back. We actually have this video here on YouTube where I found six WWF collective plates at a flea market outside. It wasn't on an inside flea market. It was on the outside of the flea market. And I paid $25 for six of them. They were all different. I think like Chris Jericho, China, Kane, Triple H, Chris Jericho, and I think Stone Cold and The Rock, I believe. But, yeah, I mean, you never know what you're going to find in, exactly. like, flea markets and things of that nature. But that's what I enjoy doing.
No, but I'm glad you mentioned about your son. He's my grandson. And I'm sorry that I left him out of it. I like to spend time with my grandson, too. And
me, too.
Yeah, his uncle just adores him. And we all got special names for him. And to me... I call him Pumpkin Butt all the time, and he loves it.
sometimes he can be a handful.
Yeah.
But we'll go ahead and go to the next question, which is, what are your thoughts on younger YWC members who do memorial videos about the old WWF and WWE wrestlers who were never born or around that wrestler's era of wrestling?
Well, I have no problem with it as long as they get their facts straight.
Yeah.
You know, if you get your facts straight, then you're good. But if you fuck up on all the shit, like, Stan the Man Stasiak, he didn't win the WWE. Yeah, he did.
Yeah.
When was this?
He won the WWE championship.
Just like the dumbass from RF Video.
You know.
Asked Jesse the Body Ventura if he was ever going to be inducted
in the Hall of Fame.
Would he go?
And he goes, I've been in the Hall of Fame. I was inducted in 2004.
Exactly. I've been in the Hall of Fame. I was inducted in 2004. He goes, oh.
That's how stupid some of these people are.
And
get your facts and then do it.
Get your facts and then come talk to me.
Yeah. You know, I have no problem with someone knows their fucking facts.
You know, that goes standard bearer.
Do your fucking research.
With us, yes, we know a lot about 80s wrestling, 90s wrestling, and so on and so forth. I'm only 26. Tommy's only 27.
I've seen a lot of wrestling in my age.
And when it comes to, you know, he was born in 89, I was born in 1990. You know, growing up, we watched wrestling all the time.
Yeah.
And not only that, but we watch that current wrestling, and we're like, how'd this come to be?
Yeah.
So we go further back. Enjoy that. How'd this come to be? We're further back. So
these kids right here, I tell you what.
It's hard to go through the 70s and the AWA.
Yes, but they did do that, and they know everything about it because they went back and they researched.
You know, do your research.
What really happened there.
You know. Like, Stan the Man Stasiak, he didn't win the WWE. What the fuck is he talking about? He won the WWE championship.
You guys,
he was a long-time champion, but he won.
People ask, you know,
Pedro
sometimes,
Morales.
Why?
Pedro Morales.
How do they know so much?
Morales was not Intercontinental. What the fuck are you talking about? He's Intercontinental champion. I hold it long, but he's Intercontinental champion.
There are some of the scribers that they were very, you know, that they were very proud of, too, and... They actually call my sons. What is that word they use for you?
And actually, Brio 35 is the one that coined the phrase, and he's also from the Google search engine of professional wrestling.
Yes, and they
well,
really.
Well, the WWF is hard to watch.
I agree. But you know, I don't mind doing that, but like. Like, I know when they were talking about inducting Kurt Angle, and you see, like,
little kids,
little five or six year olds chanting, "You suck," and it's like, you don't even know what
Kurt Angle is. You don't even know what he meant to it. You don't even know who Kurt Angle is, so what the fuck you say you suck for? Go back in there and cheer for John Cena.
You know, you got to remember one thing.
Go cheer for Jocks.
I probably told you guys this story before. I
mean, that's definitely does piss me off in a way. You know, because some of them don't know what the fuck they're talking about.
As long as you guys know exactly what you're talking about, I don't have no problem with it.
Yeah, but if you start not knowing what the fuck you're talking about, I'm going to bat ass you like the gals come home.
If you want to talk about it, go back, do your research, get the facts straight, and then, oh my God, go with it. You know, go with it. Get it.
Yep. Then they made us do it because people had their facts wrong. That's why we got over the mother.
And not only that, right there, you know, me and their mother, we took these guys to wrestling before they even knew what wrestling was.
That's what got us started on YouTube. We watched YouTube and we were seeing some of these motherfuckers not knowing anything about professional wrestling. Talking about professional wrestling. I have no fucking clue what they're talking about.
You've got That's to what do got research. Us on here.
And apparently paying off because... Yeah. Like right now, we are 70 subscribers away from hitting 500.
Yeah.
Which is...
So we're doing something right.
Fantastic. Yeah.
So the advice that I think all three of you do your research and then go for it. Hey, good luck to you.
Number three. Do you believe WWE has too many titles? And which one do you believe will eventually be retired in the future? I'm going to say it right here, right now. I think the UK title is going to be the first one to go.
Yeah.
Because the UK tournament, the viewing ship went down.
Especially when Tyler Bate won.
I wasn't a big fan of Tyler Bate.
I'm sorry. I don't see nothing there.
And too many titles. I think they have just enough. On each brand, but...
They could make them different.
Yeah. They just look shitty if they look all together.
The exact same. And then I heard they're going to change the Intercontinental and U.S.
What you guys thought of that?
You
think they have too many titles?
I think they got just enough on each show.
Yeah.
No, but just make them different.
Mm-hmm.
But I do agree with you. I think the first title, if it does roll that way, I think the first title will be gone. Will be the U.K.
What do you think?
Yeah.
U.K. as well?
Yeah, U.K.
Or you think it's going to be the purple title?
Nah, it's going to be U.K.
God, I wish
at least someone good holds that.
Please,
title.
I just want to take a minute here. Who
thought of that color scheme first?
Oh, first he thought.
Neville, change the title, please. I want you to change the title, Neville. Okay.
Well, first who thought the Tyler Bate win? Give me a break. I'm just being honest.
I was going for Pete Dunne myself.
Oh, so was I.
But
I was highly disappointed when I just saw the outcome of that. I felt like I wasted 2 days.
I wasted
2 days watching that goddamn UK tournament.
And what do I get? Tyler Bate. Fucking William Regal light.
William Regal light.
Well, you had Finn Balor light in it as well.
And he can't even hold William Regal. I'm sorry. You're not even close. To
but
that crappy Tiger Driver. Seen it before.
I enjoy it. But
I don't because I've seen it before.
Well, nobody else is using it right now.
God damn, but I've seen it before. God damn. Watch Greg Googly Moogly done it. I don't need to see it again.
Anyway, we'll go into the fourth question, which is when you decide on what wrestling merchandise you were going to purchase, do you have a particular rule that you go by?
Yeah, clearance.
I didn't
talk to you say that. I go on clearance on WWE Shop. This TNA, I don't buy shit. Because their shit is always the same. Their fucking scheme's the same. Call this number 270. their merchandise shit never changes. At least in WWE it changes. And me, I go on clearance.
Yeah. Yeah, this guy's a cheapskate, by the way. But anyway.
And speaking of that, I'm getting that AJ Styles shirt for $7.99.
But
I'm going to win, but I am.
And they know this. I buy wrestling merchandise a lot.
Yeah.
As much as I can.
But sometimes I will buy some.
You know, sometimes it has to be, you know, a wrestler that it doesn't have to be my favorite wrestler, but a wrestler I enjoy.
Well, see, I know that some of those shirts that they have for $25, they're going to put on clearance once they have a new shirt. Mm-hmm. Why wait? You might as well wait.
Yeah. You could pay,
$8.
40 to 60% off.
I'm your cheapskate.
Well, I got a point though.
He's a cheapskate.
Which is that too, but I got a point though.
Yeah. Well, and also, you know, you got to look at it this way. You know, I like special edition stuff, but the thing is, and Tommy brought this up, like they had the Brock Lesnar, thing where they had like Brock's gloves in there. They had a signed card of Brock from WrestleMania. And the DVD and everything, and it was, I think, what was it, like $50 or $60? Yeah. And I was like, man, I want to get this. But Tommy goes, you don't even like Brock Lesnar. I was like, you're fucking right. So I'm going to put it back.
Put it back.
Yeah.
You know, now, you know, coming back to the Undertaker coffin that I bought.
That's a different story.
Yeah.
I enjoy the Undertaker.
So, anyone deserves it.
Anybody likes the Undertaker.
Well, damn, I was highly pissed off Roman Reigns a little bit.
So, and
by the way, fuck you. For eliminating the fucking Booger Red.
I was gonna throw that in there.
Big bad Booger Red.
I hope you're facing the Undertaker, Russ, because I want that motherfucker to drag you down to hell, bitch.
Actually, I want to go to Walmart here soon, to get the retro Hasbro X figures that they released the new WWE Superstars.
Oh yeah.
I heard that they're selling them for $10 a pop. Which is damn good compared to...
Oh, but they have the new Hasbros, yeah.
Yeah, I want to go there and check it out.
Yeah, that actually sounds pretty good.
You know, they have Kevin Owens, Brock Lesnar. I probably won't get Brock or Roman or Cena.
I'll probably get Kevin.
And then later on, they're releasing Undertaker and Ultimate War, and I know I'm picking them two up.
Oh,
that's
all right, man.
Oh, I'm still looking for the elite package of Edge, because Edge is my favorite.
So, wrestling merchandise, we buy in bundles sometimes, DVDs.
Well, sometimes we put those DVDs on for $5,
Your local FYE, sometimes you can find them in different thrift stores.
Well, our FYE here sucks.
Ours.
Fuck,
only have two shelves.
They only got two shelves.
When they used to have a whole section.
Yeah, now their DVDs are not that good.
So...
It's sometimes we go other places to look for wrestling DVDs.
And I'm telling you, like, your DVDs, FYE sucks. They look terrible.
Exactly. And also, we got the last question, which it's funny that you brought up DVDs. Because this is supposedly the DVD king.
Uh-huh.
After Gemini 888 / Vincent, as he wants to be called now.
Virgil White.
We'll call that formal apology to the YWC for his actions.
Well, first of all, I don't accept your fucking apology.
I don't want to see your goddamn shit in the toilet. Yeah. I don't want to see you fake your fucking death.
I don't want to see you farting in the doctor's office.
Is he trying to do a Vince McMahon thing?
Exactly.
I don't want to see you farting in the doctor's office. I don't want to see you eating Diablo chili, licking it like a dog. I don't want to see you drinking fucking vinegary pickle juice. You know,
Well, after that, do you still want to take on Gemini 888/ Vincent in a wrestling quiz?
All right, Brita. This is Brita asking the question.
And Brita said he would love to see it.
Well, first of all,
he's never accepted our challenge in the first place.
Brita, he's never accepted our challenge. First, he's too pussy.
Yeah.
Okay, he's a big pussy. Okay? He says he's too busy for a girlfriend, which I've never seen. So, I don't know where.
Well, first of all, he said he's looking for a girlfriend.
He says he's got one now? And then
before that, he goes, I have a girlfriend, and then, we left to go where, blah, blah, blah. Do you have one or you don't have one?
I'll be honest,
I'm single. I'm divorced and single.
Me, I'm single and I'm proud of it.
Exactly. I love being single.
Oh, I love it. I can do whatever the fuck I want to do.
I'm widowed.
You know, alright, Brie, I'm going to tell you up front here, okay? Right here, right now, he's a pussy. Okay? Because We already issued the challenge. And I was fucking, how many months later is the challenge?
Well, actually, it's been almost a month since we challenged him.
It's been almost a month, and he hasn't sent one rebuttal.
Except
one reply.
Hold on. And Brita gave me the trash.
What you said about the NBA, that's all he said.
And Brita's awesome. He's an awesome guy. He wrote us saying, I'm going to go ahead and give you the transcript of what this challenge was. He set out a challenge to any person that likes the new era wrestling. Now, we don't love the new era wrestling. We like the new era wrestling.
There's a big difference. We don't love it. We like it.
We like it.
You know, I like some of the guys in the new era. AJ Styles.
It gets a point of change.
You know.
And he goes, and you go, you guys accepted the challenge. Send him a challenge, and he wants to talk about the NBA.
Yeah, it's true. It's true.
We're wrestling Rampage. We're not basketball Rampage.
You know, this ain't...
wrestling got to do with with the basketball games?
You know, and I actually like this guy. We ain't Slug Daddy, okay, that talks about that stuff. You know what I'm saying? Really? I actually like that channel, by the way. Really? So I'm not bashing it.
Oh, yeah.
Because I actually like him. He's a nice guy. And, you know, I'm just saying, he's never going to respond. He never will. And, you know, he's... And him saying that he issues an apology to everybody, I ain't accepting your fucking apology. I spit on your fucking apology. So, fuck you.
I'm going to tell you something. I will do something to do. I would love to see a one-on-one face-to-face conversation.
You're
I would love to see that. I really would.
But he doesn't want to. He
don't want to do it.
Now, like, you people may say I'm prejudiced or whatever, but I'm going to tell you what: the winner will be my son that comes out of it. I guarantee you.
Yeah, because what's he going to talk about? Farts.
He's either going to talk about pickle juice, Diablo sauce, farts, or NBA, or not having a girlfriend / having a girlfriend.
Yeah.
He drinks pickle juice.
Yeah.
Or talk about shitting in the toilet.
Oh, yeah, well, of course that, yeah. Well, see, the thing
What's
is...
What's exciting about that?
He will not accept the challenge.
It's been a month.
Right. We sent him the challenge. What do you say back? And Tommy was wearing a Dallas Mavericks shirt at the time because Tommy got the shirt for $5 at a goddamn store. It was just a shirt.
A fucking shirt.
And he goes, the Mavs suck.
I remember this.
The Mavs suck. My Warriors destroyed them.
Well, here's the thing about the Warriors. I don't see them rocking anything. Come on, you
only got one star player.
No. Now they got Kevin Durant. The only reason he's there because he's mooching.
Exactly.
He knew I gotta ride the coattails to get an NBA ring because I know I can't get it any other way. He's doing a LeBron James.
Of course.
You know, mooches off another team to get another ring. He done that to us in Miami. That's why Miami sucks. You know.
But I don't think he will.
He's not going to answer. It's been a month. I haven't heard from him. He hasn't sent one message, one rebuttal, nothing, not even a video, not a response. And I don't think we're going to see him anytime soon. And he haven't seen one comment.
He keeps doing his fart videos.
He keeps doing his fart videos and juice videos and I don't even watch his channel anymore, so I don't know what he posts on there.
I just don't understand.
Then he said he was going to retire.
Then he said he was going to retire. You don't retire from YouTube, you just don't make videos.
You just quit.
You know, you just...
You just quit.
You know, yeah, you're not... Quit. You just stop and make videos. That's your retirement.
And the thing is, he comes back the next day...
And starts making videos.
I thought you were retired.
It's a two-way street, brother. Which one you take? You either not making videos or you're going to make videos.
I enjoy making videos.
I enjoy making videos, okay?
What did he
do? I like making videos.
Well, what I want to know is the death thing. Did he commit suicide or did somebody kill him?
No, he faked his own death.
He said it was his ex-wife writing the stuff. Like, there was nobody in the video. It was just, like, text. And it says, this is his ex-wife, Jennifer. Well, even though he has a girlfriend. But anyway.
And everyone was up in arms about that, too.
He was stabbed last night after work or some shit like that. I was like, come on now. This is fucking stupid.
What, is he trying to write a storyline for himself?
I guess so.
Or what? I mean, my God. And I can come up with a better plot than that.
And the funny thing was, he keeps saying, he goes, my Gemini 888 character, my Gemini 888 character, I'm Vincent. Listen, Here at Wrestling Rampage, we're no
we're fucking characters. We're real people.
I'm a dick in real life, and I'm proud to be a dick.
Tommy is
He is. I gotta say, he is a dick in real life.
I'm an asshole in real life, and I'm proud to be a fucking asshole. That's the way I am.
Here's the thing. We are not actors. We're not portraying to be other people. Okay? We are who we are.
You know, I'm no fucking character. I'm a real person. I'm a fucking asshole.
How come we don't give a fuck what we say?
You know, but I'm not playing to be an asshole. I'm a real fucking asshole.
But with that being said, that was 5 questions with Wrestling Rampage. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, facebook.com/WrestlingRampage2. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter @WrestleRampage. Hit that subscribe button. Because we're going to bring you up.
Yeah, we're going to bring you. God, and yes. We got, and can I give him a heads up?
Yes, go ahead.
We got something about Elimination Chamber coming up.
That's right. We got some special Elimination Chamber videos coming up.
Yes.
Oh, my God, yes.
Stay tuned
We also got the giveaway coming
up. Yes, and we got the giveaway coming up. Remember.
Oh, Lord, we're going to be doing that one.
Yes. So make sure you guys come back to the Wrestling Rampage YouTube channel. Hit that subscribe button. You'll get all of our updated videos as they get uploaded. And don't forget to also go on WWEshop.com. Get your Chronic Cure bracelet.
Good cause.
Great cause.
God help us.
Wrestling Rampage is that cream that rises to the top.
Cream of the crop, baby.
And nobody does it better. Suck it, Gemini.